Peter Kubelka. I met for the first time. I had heard of Peter Kubelka's work in Vienna, and he brought his film Arnulf Rainer for the premiere at that festival, at the Knokke-Le-Zoute Film Festival in the Experimental Film Festival in Knokke-Le-Zoute in December 1964. And I saw the film, and I was amazed, and I could not believe that, because the rest of the films at that festival were not that exciting. And then it comes Arnulf Rainer. I see the film, and then I hear the film ends, and there is silence, and I see that nobody is excited about it except me. And I walk out into the lobby, and I see this solid, pretty stocky young man walking there back and forth and sort of very depressed. So I knew it has to be Peter. He knew that the reaction will be, you know, very negative. So I knew that it was Peter Kubelka. So I came and introduced myself, and that's how we met. And so our friendship began there. Later he came in 66. He was for 1 year the film in charge of United Nations Film Department, and and he was editing at that time Unsere Afrika Reise, another of his masterpieces, great films. And he was also doing a lot of, during that period, he also became judo champion of the New York State. And of course, you can imagine what competition there was in New York State. But he, and then the press after he won, the press asked him, the newspaper photographers, to repeat and demonstrate some of his techniques. And during the demonstration, he twisted his wrist. And that was the end of his judo career. He's still very good, and he can, you know, actually, if you talk about Peter Kubelka, here is an anecdote. Anthology's opening was on Anthology Film Archives, took place on 30th of November 1917. We had a big party, everybody was there, not only avant-garde, but, you know, Otto Preminger, and, you know, those were all our friends. Preminger was very friendly to the avant-garde. He said, when I go home, you know, I will beat up my kid because he's not making films like you, he used to say. So, everybody there. And the policy at Anthology in those days was that nobody is permitted to go into the theater after the show starts, because it was a very specially designed theater, designed by Peter Kubelka, of course, where it was all black, and the seats designed so that you could not see who is sitting before you, in front of you, or even who is on the side of you. They were separated, sort of like blinders. And if there was an empty seat, of course, if you walk in, you won't know where that seat is. So what's the sense walking in? So the rule was not to permit anybody in. So there is, we are having a great party. And then somebody, the big guy, actually, it was Ira Cohen, was trying to walk in. And the woman in charge of the door said, no, you cannot go in. So who is going to stop me? And Peter was there. So Peter says, please don't go in. There is this rule. Says, who is going to stop me? Says, I'm going to stop you. So Peter, of course, was pretty, you know, bulky and solid, but not as bulky and solid as Ira Cohen. So Ira looked at, are you going to start? And he is marching in. So Peter just took It was so fast that, but I think he took his, he was in a long coat, took his coat like with one hand, one, two fingers, wrapped up, twisted, and there were a corn on the ground. So he kind of corn does not believe it, he cannot believe it. He stands up and he's again on the floor, on the ground. So four times he got up, and he, because he just could not believe it, every time he went, was on the floor. Then Peter had enough. So he just put his finger on him, and he could, Ira Cohen couldn't move. And then he let him go. So Ira Cohen realized he cannot do anything against Peter. So he went, walked out, smashing every plate that the servers, women, girls that we had and Jade had in their hands for their guests. He just smashed them all and he walked out. That was the opening. But we all had a great time. It was a great opening.